Sure. Boss and Jimmie here, Stogie Press. I'm sitting with Tony Bellotto with La Barba Cigars at the 2019 PCA trade show.
That was the announcement last
Yes.
I wasn't. I was setting up, so I missed it.
Yeah. PCA now. IPC PCR is gone. PCA is now the name. Premium Cigar Association. Tony.
Yes, sir.
Last year you came out with this Ricochet.
Yes.
Awesome cigar.
I know you like that one.
I love that cigar, especially the Toro. The Toro. Talk to me about this new rendition.
So this is this guy. So this is. Ricochet initially was kind of the, I wanted to really get back to my roots in wine. So that's where the term Ricochet came from, getting back, you know. The original one was the San Andres Mexican wrapper. And I really like that wrapper, the wrappers that are coming from that area. So I started to explore and they're doing a lot of new things in Mexico. So on this cigar we were using a Mexican sun-grown wrapper, so obviously. You could probably maybe call it a Mexican bono wrapper. We call it Mexi-Sol. Mexi-Sol. The fillers are from Pennsylvania, Nicaragua, and Dominican. And the binders from Dominican. So it's very Bordeaux-like in style. A little bit of minerality, but you still get that graham cracker sweetness from the bono wrapper. Medium body, but very approachable. I think this starts shipping.
Shipping in two. And what's the price point on these?
Same as the regular Ricochet, is $8 to $12. There's a Coronita size, so a little Corona. There's a Gran Robusto size, 5.5 by 2. There's a Torpedo, which is my first Torpedo. I've never done a Torpedo.
Okay.
And a 6x60.
6x60. Do you sell a lot of 6x60s?
Still, we still do, yeah. It's actually, it's weird. Some markets are very 6x60 heavy. Some markets are very 5x50 or less 50. You know, I think it depends on the weather. And it depends on the momentum.
Now, when you blend the cigar, what do you blend it to first?
In regards to
the size.
I always blend it with this.
With this one?
Yeah.
That's your base. And
yes. Yeah, so we always, Henderson and I always start with this.
So are you recommending a wine to pair with this?
Absolutely, I would definitely recommend French style Bordeaux or Cabernets. You can go on the California wine side of things. California's maybe a little bit too far forward for the spice this house, but you're gonna get a lot of graham cracker, a lot of chocolate out of this. So I would stick to French style Bordeaux and European wines, maybe Spanish.
Well, last year you did some work with Colton.
Yes. He just walked by, actually.
I saw him.
Yeah.
So what are you doing this year?
He's actually instrumental in everything that we do. So he's my distributor, but he also helps me with blending. So we kind of like to do it as a team. So he's very instrumental in helping me figure out, because he was a cigar promoter before I left. I respect his palate. Pretty much anyone in the industry. So he helps me do almost everything. As far as collaborative efforts this year, we don't have any plans.
You're not one
up. But we might see something.
Now, are you going on a road show with this?
Yes. Yeah, so as soon as they start shipping, I'll be on the road. I mean, I never really get off the road.
Yeah.
But I'll be on the road with this as soon as they start shipping.
When do you come to Florida?
Whenever you want. Here's my card. You call me. You let me know.
Yes, you should come by, and I'll definitely make sure that.
I'll take you to dinner.
No, she'll cook you dinner.
Oh,
that's what we do for the industry.
Well, I'm Italian. So.
She cook anything, man.
Beautiful.
She'll blow your mind.
Stealing pens? So I stole.
That's the whole idea. We bring in anybody to the industry. Comes through Melbourne, Florida. Have an open invite. Just let us know a day or two ahead of time. We're coming in and what you like, and she'll put together a dinner, and then we'll go inside my lounge in the garage.
That's perfect.
77 degrees, beautiful, air conditioned air in there. We just sit back and enjoy some wine.
I love it. That's perfect.
got this. Are you going to continue with the Ricochet brand and building it?
Yeah, I have one more specific cigar in mind for this project. I'm working on it now. I want to see where it takes me. If I don't find anything else for this specific project, then I'll start. But if I keep finding things for it, and finding great tobaccos for it, we'll see how long this brand or brand part of La Barba lasts. But so far, I've been more than happy with the original Ricochet, and now this new one is phenomenal. So this was very bold.
Yeah. Bold comparison. And with these are being manufactured where?
At Tobacco Railway in the show. So the same as all the other.
Yep.
I plan to continue to work with Will Henderson forever. He's like a brother to me. And the quality of the cigars and the quality of the cigars that we're getting now is just unreal. So we're going to keep growing together. I mean, we started with 10 rollers. So between Room 101, Cornwall, and La Barba, all the products we have being produced there. My big thing is family, and we're a family business. And Rob, Matt, myself, and everybody on the project are family.
It's good to see you back doing it again. Final question, which I'll probably ask everybody. So, as you know, yesterday they make the big announcement, rebranded the show, going at the Premium Cigar Association. And they've also noted very, very clearly that next year they will have CigarCon.
Okay.
So they will have consumers. The way it's working, they said, is that retailers, you have to get the CigarCon ticket through retail. So retail's got to bring you in one day, 6 hours, first day at show. Are you ready for this?
I don't know. I was sitting in my booth during
4,500 people.
I went to Cigar Fest last year. They have 6,500. So I saw what that was. So if it's anything like that, it's going to be nothing short of intense. I mean, I'm ready for whatever the industry has to offer. I'm happy that I think that anything that pushes our industry forward is a good thing. And I'll never say that. I'll never shy away from that. I just want to continue to make sure that this industry has a voice, and that we continue to make good cigars, and that we continue to get to the people that make the cigars.
Absolutely.
So however we can make that happen is the most important thing.
You're good. Tony Bellotto, Barba Cigars.
Me.
Check them out. Thank you.